Ready? Good afternoon. I'm Doug Decker of Lofty Ambitions, and I'm here with Mark Lee, shuttle veteran on 4 missions. We have a few questions for you. In your career as a shuttle astronaut, what are you most proud of?
Well, probably the number one thing is working on the Hubble Space Telescope. Very personal, satisfying as far as I, you know, worked on it before it even launched, developing some of the tools that we flew on board, and then having been on a repair mission, did 3 spacewalks. And it's not so much the repairs that you take pride in, is that you're helping science advance because the Hubble has done such a remarkable job over the years of advancing our understanding of the universe.
Is there anything in your career that you'd do over again?
I can't think of too much. You know, as you're going through it, you go, well, I wish I was on this flight, or I wish I was on that flight. Kind of in the end, things always work out. You know, I was able to do, you know, 4 spacewalks. At the time I retired, that was a lot. People are doing a little bit more now, but having flown on a jet, flew the jetpack around, tested that out. There's only been a few people got to fly untethered in space, so that was a lot of fun, and then Hubble was great as well.
Actually, can you say a little bit about that experience of flying untethered?
All right. Well, the neat thing about it is this device was made, SAFER is the name of it, Simplified Aid for EVA Rescue, is for people, if they're on station or the shuttle and they become disconnected because their tether breaks or they make a mistake or something else, it's a self-rescue device. It's the only way to get back. I mean, it's not like you can, you know, throw out a safety line or there's a lifeguard or somebody else to come and get you. So, but flying it, maybe one of the neater parts about flying it was training for it, because we had to develop something. You know, it wasn't like the manned maneuvering unit where they had a 6-degree of freedom simulator out in Denver. We finally came up with virtual reality was the best way to build a model and train for it. And we started pretty much pioneer. That was over, you know, it was 21 years ago that we developed some of those techniques. Then you could had to have, you know, fairly powerful computers to run this simulation. Now you can run it on your, you know, laptop computer. But using virtual reality not only for that, but we ended up using the same lab for arm training, and it basically took away the expense of maintaining physical mock-ups, because we could do everything sitting there looking, you know, through a pair of goggles, just like, you know, if you were in orbit. So that's the neat part about it.
My own background, that's an area of research for me. Okay. I'm a computer scientist by training.
All right.
Just amazing stuff.
All right.
Yesterday afternoon, we put Atlantis on permanent display at the Visitor Center. It had flown 33 missions out of a planned 100 mission life.
Right.
Do you think we quit flying the shuttle too soon?
No, I don't think so. I mean, we didn't expect to have 2 accidents in 135 flights. It's just not too expensive to process, too expensive to maintain. And, you know, even a small problem could end in catastrophe. I mean, a piece of foam falling off should not destroy a shuttle, you know. So there were just too many, you know, problems to keep it flying. And let me see what else. And it's time to get away from just hauling people back and forth to low Earth orbit. It's time to go explore again.
But actually, that's perfect segue to my final question. If you talk to 4 astronauts, you get about 8, maybe 9 opinions
right.
of what we should do next.
Right.
Mars, Moon, asteroid, Lagrange point?
I personally don't think an asteroid would get people excited. I think going to Mars is what our objective ought to be. And if we have to go to the Moon first to try out some of the components, you know, that's fine. But we ought to head to Mars, you know, as soon as we can.
Mark Lee, thank you very much for your time this afternoon.
You're welcome.
We appreciate